What's up guys, this is Destiny Cat and welcome to another character guide video. Made a few of these in the past, but today I'm going to be guiding Collector, which is actually my main in this game. I did actually make a Collector guide a while back, but I wasn't very happy with it. I thought it was kind of underdeveloped and didn't really touch on a lot of the things that I wanted to touch about. I actually also wanted to wait on making the Collector guide, the new one, until MK11 Aftermath came out. So that's why I haven't made it yet, but now that MK11 Aftermath has released and it's a blast, guys, by the way, play this game if you're not doing it. This game is a blast. It's fun. It's has a lot of cool shit you can do. Like, you know, you can learn how to flawless block. You can learn all the combos for your characters, all the neutral game. You know, the crushing blows, all that, the fatal blows, and all that. It's a really good game. So definitely my favorite game that I'm playing currently. But yeah, today we're gonna guide Collector. And I'm gonna guide the only version I play, which is Back in the Pack, which is the one that has the it gets three things. It gets the teleport, it gets the command grab, and it gets the up mace, which is a high attack. That is all it gets. But yeah, let's go over some of the stuff. So Collector's got let's go over some of his normals first. So standing one is pretty good. Standing one goes into 1-3, which is one of your main whiff punishing tools. So, you know, or just punishing tools. So if you see, you know, Scorpion do like a teleport, you block it, you can do 1-3. And that's a very good starter for your combos. Stand 2 is pretty okay. It's a really good anti-air. Because stand 2 goes into stand 2, 1 plus 3, 4. Which is his main... which is his, like, main anti-air move. It has a crushing blow on it as well, so that's something you also want to be using. Standing 3 goes into 3-2. Which is a... mid to overhead string, or high to overhead string, excuse me. It's not very good because most of the time you don't really aren't gonna use that because it doesn't really do anything for you. There's no mix up here, you know, you don't have a low off of standing free or anything, so it's not a very good button. I never use it personally, almost never. So yeah, that is like all his like buttons. We're gonna go into his pokes now. His best poke is down 3. Let me see how fast is down 3, I can't remember. Down 3 is 9 frames, so it's pretty slow. But it does have a lot of range. You see how far it hits the opponent. What's really good about down 3 is that when it hits, you get either you get a strike throw game where you can do either down 3 into command grab, or you can do down 3 into forward 1. So we're gonna touch on that later. Down 1 is okay. It's not very fast. I think it's like 7 frames as well. 8 frames actually. So it's very bad. It's not very fast. It's actually a very bad down 1. It's okay to get out of pressure, but it's, you know, it's not something you want to be using all the time. You mainly use this to combo in the corner because the optimal requires a few down ones. Then his down 4 is pretty good. See, his down 3 has a little bit more range, but His down 4 does actually is actually very good, so you use this in combination with the down 3 to control neutral and control space with it. It does recover pretty fast, so you can do like a bunch of these. You're very fast. So it's pretty good. Obviously his down 2 is very good anti-air. So you should be using his down 2 for anti-airing. And also you also use it for his like BMBs, his optimal BMBs, which is like what I'm gonna go into later. Alright, let's talk about some of his very good strings. So standing 4 is very good. I didn't actually go with this when I was talking about the normals, but standing 4 is one of his best tools. See how much range it has and hits the opponent from all the way over here. It also goes into his one of his launcher, which is 4-4-3. Which is a high mid low. You can force block the second hit, but you have to be kind of respecting the low, so you can actually loop this a lot. You can do like standing 4 into another standing 4, or standing 4 into down 3, or standing 4 into bowler cancel. Let's see how I can do that. Or standing 4 into an ace cancel. Like that. Or like the base go, you know. There's a lot of little mind games you can do here. So that is one of the tools you want to be using a lot with Collector, is standing 4. It's very good, also because if you see it hit, you just go into the full string, which will combo them. Go into a full combo. His other very good tool is his forward 1. It's only minus 1 on block, which is very good for pressure and staggers. So you can do forward 1 into another forward 1 and go into forward 1-2. If you see forward 1-2 hit, you obviously go into bowler. Medium bowler, or amplified bowler, excuse me, to get that damage, starting his combos and stuff. So that is two of his like best tools, standing 4 and forward 1. Another one of his really good strings is back 2-3. See this hit, you're going to down back 3. You can medium bend for some more damage if you really want to, or amplify for some more damage, excuse me. And if you don't see a hit, you can either just let it rip, you can go into teleport, or you can go into the mace. Alright, so I'm just gonna put my opponent to block here. So forward 1-2, alright. If you see forward 1-2 hit, you go into bowler. If you don't see it hit, you have a few options. You can be YOLO about and going for the overhead or low, which I personally never do because it's like it's too risky, you know. You don't wanna like risk getting punished because you only get like 5% off it or whatever, so it's like whatever, you don't wanna do that. His best option in my opinion is to go into teleport. And then spending a medium bar to go far, which you do by holding forward when you do the teleport. And this is actually really good because it puts you kind of in the range of his forward 4 and forward 3, which didn't cover yet. Forward 4-3 is also one of his really good tools because you can go into forward 3, 1-2-3. So, you know, if you see this hit, you go into bowler. If you don't see it, then go into teleport. Or if you don't have any bar, you can go into down back 3 for some more damage. So that is like, you know, what you want to do. You can also do teleport after you know, standing 4 or forward 3 to get some distance. And it's really hard to punish this. I don't think any character can punish it personally if you do into the far one. But it's really good for keeping distance and, you know, to keep yourself safe because you're minus 7 off this, which is not very good. You don't want to be minus 7 and be right in your face. You'd rather be away from the opponent and be a little bit safer. So spending a bar is definitely worth it every time, I must say. I think it's really good. Alright, so that's pretty much all of his, like, you know, basic tools and how you should be using them. So use forward 1 a lot, use your command grab a bunch. Your command grab is one of his best tools. If they start jumping it, you can answer them with standing 2. That is, you know, the basic idea of it. So keep command grabbing them, keep them guessing, keep forward running them, keep standing forward them from this range, you know. Try to keep yourself away. He's very good at like the space. This is like where Collector wants the opponent. He either wants to be here or he wants to be like right in your face and doing forward ones on you and down ones and things like that and down threes. So that is like, you know, what you want to be doing with Collector. Alright, let's go over some of his basic combos. So his basic combo is, you know, anything into bowler. So it could be 1-3 into bowler, or it could be 4-1-2 into bowler. Anything into bowler. And then jump 2. 4-4-3. Micro dash down 2. Down 1 into down back 3. Or command grab. Which is like his basic combo, so let me show you here. I usually don't drop this, actually. I'm pretty good at consistently getting this combo, like definitely online stuff. Okay, now I can't do it. Because I got stuck right now. There we go. That's his like optimal combo. You can actually get the down 2 into 1-3, which is very hard to do, but it is possible. But I personally never go for that because it's very difficult. I just go for this instead. The reason why you want to go into down back three and not into command grab is because you get corner carry and you leave yourself at the same distance that you would if you do command grab, and you really want to be at this distance where you can dash up and command grab them, or you can dash up and forward one them, or just, you know, dash up stand two if you think you're gonna jump. That's kind of the idea of collector, is that you really want to, like, you know, always be at the space where you can always command grab them, because office command grab you get throw loops. And if you've seen Sonic Fox play collector at a tournament a while back, you'll see he'll do this a lot. He'll command grab him a bunch. It's really what you want to do with his character, with his character variation. You want to really want to use your command grab a lot because it's one of his best tools. It's a 12 frame mid that you can't jump. You can't even, excuse me, that you can't duck. You have to jump out of it. So it's like, you know, it's really oppressing. And you can do so much damage with it. A lot of collector players, they like to go for throws. I personally am not a fan of it. I don't see why you would go for throw and leave the opponent at full screen or, like, you know, mid screen. And when you can just go for a command grab and leave the opponent close to you, so you can command grab them over and over again. That's personally my opinion, so I never throw with collector. Only for that, you know, one time brutality or whatever. But yeah, that is some of his basic combos. That is like his basic combo, is just the 1-3 into Bola, or 4-1-2 into Bola. And then into that. You can also do this. If you're gonna break away, because the problem is if they break away right here, that's something that a lot of people don't know. But if they break away at the right time when you're doing this string or this combo right here, like right here, while you're doing down one into down back three, if they break away right there, then they can actually full combo punish you. So sometimes if I think I'm gonna break away, I go for down one into mace, which leaves me in very safe if they try to break away. So, you know, that's really what I want to do. And if you see this hit, you can go in for stand freeze to optimal, unless you are close, so you can do jump 2 into 1-3, into Bola. But if you think they're gonna break away, you can do a little bit of Bola cancelling. I like doing this a lot because I don't want to get punished for trying to launch them, so if I think they're gonna break away, I just, you know, cancel my Bola, and I get a nice okay here after breakaway. So that's really what you want to be doing. Alright, let's go take a look at the corner. In the corner, you can't get a down 2 combo in the corner, but you can get a lot of damage. You can get like 36%. I did the wrong there, but alright, let me show you here. That's like the optimal. It's 36%. It's very easy and it does a lot of damage. A lot of collector players, they do this like that, which is fine, but I've actually discovered that you can actually get a backdash and you can get a jump in. Instead of a jump up, you can get a jump in, and that's much easier to link, in my opinion. So I don't see any collector players doing that. I don't know why, because it's like it's much easier to do the combo when you do that, because a lot of time you're gonna drop this. I find it a little bit difficult to drop, or to consistently do anyway. So that's just, you know, that's just what you want to be doing. Alright, so that is like your basic game plan, you know. Combo them a lot, you know, do your down 2 combos. Keep them at bay with 4-4, forward 3, standing 4, forward 3, down 4, down 3. You know, your 1-3 string for whiff punishing, or for just punishing, or 4-2-2 for whiff punishing. I didn't cover that, but that's also something you want to be doing. And your 4-1-2 up close. 4-1, 4-1-2, and command grab, of course. That is your basic idea. And then if you see something get blocked, you just go into far teleport to keep yourself safe and keep yourself at a distance. So that is the idea. You can play very lame with collector. You can just like teleport to, you know, full screen all day and then wait for your opponent to, you know, catch up to you if you have a life lead. Keep them at range with your bolas, your 4-3, and your, you know, standing 4, things like that. By the way, this string, 4-3-1-2-3. Try to mix them a little bit, you know, don't go for the full string all the time. Don't go for, you know, sometimes go for 4-3 just by that by itself, or go for 4-3-1, or go for 4-3-1-2. You know, try to, you know, keep them guessing on if you're gonna finish the string or not, because you don't want to just, like, you know, do this constantly, because that's going to that's really going to you know, be very predictable. So try to, you know, try to mix it up a bit and be a little bit weird with it, and yeah, do that. Alright, let's talk about some of his crushing blow combos, what you can get out of his crushing blows, and just his crushing blows in general. So I'm just gonna put on easy crushing blows so I can show you. So if you catch someone rolling with your command grab, that is like really good for you. That is like really you know, that's a read you want to go for a lot. Because you get, let me show you how much damage you get off this. Oh, dropped it. This is just mid-screen, by the way. This is not in the corner, so mid-screen. I dropped it. Alright, but that's of course if you catch a roll, then... There we go. Look at that damage. That is 47%. And they can't even break away because they just used the bar to roll. So that is like, that is really good for you. In a corner you get way more, you get like 49%, let me show you. Look at that. 49%. It's not even that hard to do. The reason you do standing 3 into baller and not like 4-2-2 or 1-3 into baller is because it does the most damage. From what I found, you can see standing 3 does like 5%, this one does 4%, 4-2-2 does 5%, but it scales more. So I found that doing standing 3 is you know, the most damage you're gonna get. Also, if you convert from this standing 3 into baller, is like the best way to go. Because it does look like this is more damage. From what I know, this is actually this actually scales a lot more. So that's why I want to do it. Off down 2, you get much of the same. You know, very simple combo, and that's 43%. And in the corner, you get again way more. So that, and then if someone tries to jump in, jump forward, I'm gonna say, jump forward, and same with that. And if you try to do like a jump 2 or jump 3, you get a crushing blow off that. You can even do this into bowler if they're above, right above your head, which is really good. So you know, use this a lot. Then one of his other crushing blows is, I think his last one is his back 4-2 crushing blow. Looks like that. If you charge it fully, then the opponent gets you know hit by it, and yeah, it's not very good. But I've actually caught people with it sometimes, very rarely, but it has happened that I've caught people with it sometimes. So that is something you can't be going for if you wanna, you know, because that's what you wanna do with Collector. You really wanna use your cancels a lot in neutral as well. Charge this a lot, you know, let it go, and at some point charge it and then let it go, or charge it and cancel it, and you know, be very weird about it, you know, try to keep your opponent guessing. A lot of Collector players don't use this enough, but it's actually very good to use after block strings, because you get a little bit of damage on hit, and if you know, the opponent blocks it, you can obviously hit confirm, of course, into that, which is the best way to go. But if they don't block it, you get a little bit of damage, and if they do block it, you're keeping it safe. You can obviously interrupt it, but if you don't use it too much and use it just enough to where the opponent isn't sure of when to interrupt it, then it's a very good tool to use. Alright, let's talk about some of his fatal blow combos, and you know, the kind of damage you can get. Let's see, what do I have? There we go. So I think this does the most damage. That's just, you know, the basic combo into fatal blow. And what's really good about this is that it is unbreakable. That's one thing that's really good about Collector, is that his fatal blows, or excuse me, a lot of his combos, you can make them unbreakable just by doing, you know, this. So that's really good. Or you can obviously make it unbreakable and do a little bit more damage by doing things like that. Obviously off of, you know, a command grab or something, you get a lot of damage. So, you know, if you do like command grab into fatal blow combo, it does like a bunch of damage. See if I can show you right here. Easy crushing blows, there we go. So if you do like... like that. Like, that's a lot of damage. But yeah, I think that's pretty much everything for Collector. I'm trying to cover most of the things that I think you should do with the character and things like that. So, hope you guys enjoy this guide, and I'll definitely make some more guides if I try, if I, you know, find more characters that I want to guide. I might make one for Rajin Raiden, because I've been playing him a little bit later recently. Not too much though, but I might start playing him again. I played him a lot a while back, but I might start playing him again, so... if you guys want to see that, then please leave a comment, and as always, tell me what you think about the video. Tell me if there's something I've missed, or if there's something Collector that you're doing that you find very useful. As always, this is Testing Cat, signing out.